Hi guys, it's MTG here. Today I'm going to be going over some more Samsung Galaxy Note 8 tips and tricks that you may not have known about. Let's get right into it. The first feature that I'm going to be talking about today is Bixby Quick Commands. This feature will allow you to say one phrase to trigger multiple actions on your phone. To set this feature up, go into Bixby, click the menu button, and go to My Bixby. From here, scroll down to Quick Commands and click the box under it. From this screen, you'll be able to add all of the Bixby commands that you want to execute from a single phrase. In this instance, I will set a Bixby Quick Command for when I'm about to sleep. I'll add a Bixby command to turn on Do Not Disturb. I'll also add a command to turn the blue light filter on. Lastly, I'll have Bixby tell me the weather for tomorrow. But if you search this command, nothing will pop up. But you can get around this by first asking Bixby the question, "What's the weather tomorrow?"
"Tuesday looks like it will be clear with a high of 80.
Then when you go to select a command, you can select from history and choose the question that you just picked. Now you can add a quick command. Good night. Once this is set, now you can say, good night.
Got it. Do not disturb is on now. The blue light filter opacity is already set to 50. Tuesday looks like it will be clear with a high of 80. All done.
If you want to find out more things Bixby can do, check the description for a link to my Bixby walkthrough video. The next feature that I'm going to be talking about today involves the S Pen that lives in the bottom right corner of your Note 8. Quick Glance will allow you to have a little shortcut of whatever app you want to be able to quickly glance at. To glance back at an app, all you have to do is hover the S Pen over it and lift the S Pen up again to go back. To activate this feature, you'll have to click the Air Command icon. This feature may not be here by default, so if it isn't, scroll to Add Shortcuts and select Glance. Now, when you want to create a shortcut that you can glance at, simply click the Air Command icon and then glance. You'll be able to move the shortcut to any corner of the screen, and when you're done using it, you can just drag it up to the top. The next set of hidden features are ways to activate the shutter button when taking a selfie. The first method is palm raise. When your phone is on the front camera, you'll be able to hold your palm up by your face and a timer will begin. This should help out when multiple people are in shot, so everyone knows when the picture is going to be taken, or when you want to stay perfectly still when shooting. The next capture method is a heart rate sensor tap. On the back of the Note 8, between the fingerprint sensor and the cameras, there's a heart rate sensor. You'll be able to tap this area to instantly capture a photo. This feature should also help you take less shaky photos with the front camera. Both these features should be on by default, but if they aren't on for you, click the settings icon and scroll down to shooting methods. Here, you'll be able to toggle each on. The Note 8 is a snappy phone, but there's a feature on all Android devices that will instantly make your phone appear a lot faster. To activate this feature, you'll have to turn on developer options. To do this on your phone, go to settings and scroll down to about phone. From here, scroll down to build number and tap it 6 times. Since I already have it activated, nothing will happen on my phone. But once you complete this, there will now be developer options at the bottom of your settings menu. Click this, and you'll be able to scroll down and find various settings regarding animation scale. For each of the animation options, you'll be able to set the animation speed to half of what it is now, or you'll be able to turn all of them off. Once they are off, you'll notice the difference. There will no longer be an animation when you open and close apps and when you navigate menus. The always-on display also has a cool hidden feature. Like on the S8 and S8 Plus, you can access media controls even when your screen is off. If you're playing any sort of media, you'll be able to access the media controls by double-clicking the time and swiping either left or right. From here, you'll be able to pause and play the media and skip forward or back a song. The last hidden feature I'm going to be talking about today could prove to be very useful because of just how big the Note 8 screen is. Don't get me wrong, the Note 8 is my daily driver and I love it, but there are many times where I'm forced to use two hands when using it because there are certain menu buttons that are impossible to reach otherwise. But Samsung has implemented a feature that can shrink down the content of the screen so that you can reach it all with one hand. This feature works by sliding up from either corner of the phone. From here, the entire screen will shrink down to just the corner that you gestured from. You'll now be able to click menu buttons that were hard to reach, and you'll also still be able to navigate through your phone as normal. And to exit this mode, just tap anywhere outside of the screen. To turn this feature on, go into Settings, Advanced Features, and toggle on One-Handed Mode. If you click this, you'll be able to select whether you want to activate it by gesture, or tapping the home button 3 times. Hopefully you found some of these tips helpful. If you like this video, please give this video a thumbs up. I'm working on a lot of new content right now, so make sure to click the logo down below to subscribe and click the notification bell to stay up to date on my latest video. Check the description for links to my social media accounts, and as always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.